Welcome to Getting Started with FME Server. This tutorial gives you hands-on experience with this component of the FME Data Integration Platform. This four-part tutorial series covers basic elements of FME Server. We take a tour of the FME Server web interface and run a sample workspace. We publish our own workspace with data to FME Server. We modify our workspace to create a self-serve data access portal. And finally, we use FME Server automations to schedule a workspace to run at a set time. If you wish to work through the exercises too, there are a few requirements. First, both FME Server and FME Desktop require to be installed. They must also already be licensed. This tutorial covers neither installation nor licensing. At this point, if you do not have FME Server or Desktop, but want to try them out, please visit our website, safe.com, for a free trial. Sample data and workspaces are attached to the main landing page for this tutorial on knowledge.safe.com. It's recommended you download these, as we use these files throughout the tutorial series. Otherwise, you may carry out the tutorial using workspaces of your own. Before starting, let's briefly mention the purpose of FME Server. FME Server is part of the FME Data Integration Platform. It takes data integration models, called workspaces, from FME Desktop and deploys them on a web-based system. This provides an abundance of automation capabilities, such as event-driven actions, scheduling, and notifications, plus a series of centralized data services to help manage and deliver data. Let's start by taking a quick tour of the FME Server web interface. The simplest way to open the web interface is typing the server host name as a URL in a web browser window. The host name is specified during the installation. A shortcut labeled web interface also exists on the Windows Start menu. For the purpose of this tutorial, log in with the default username author and with author as the password too. If the accounts on your system have been modified, please log into an account with similar authoring permissions. Logging in leads us to the FME Server homepage. On the left side is a menu panel. It supplies access to all the tools necessary for data integration tasks with FME Server. Above that, in the top left, is an FME logo. Clicking this always returns you to this home page. A menu button here can be used to hide the menu panel. Below the menu, in the bottom left, is information about the version and build number of your FME server, plus the platform on which it is operating. In the top right corner of the home page, there is an account icon, where you can change your account details, manage tokens, switch to dark mode, or log out of the server. The main part of the interface is made up of a series of panels. The Help panel contains links to support information. Here you can access documentation about FME Server or access the FME community. The community is a great resource for asking for help from experts or reading knowledge base articles about FME. There are also links to various demonstration and training resources, plus the REST API documentation. The panels for recent jobs, projects, and workspaces are all currently empty. That's because this is a fresh and unused installation. The two green buttons above the panels allow you to customize and organize the panel layout. Now let's run a workspace. Navigate to the Run Workspace page by clicking the Run Workspace button on the side menu. Here you have access to workspaces published to FME Server repositories. Think of a repository as a folder in which workspace and related items are stored. There are four repositories pre-installed with FME Server, although without being an administrator, you may not see all of them. For this tutorial, we are only interested in the samples repository. Go ahead and select it. Choose which workspace to run. The drop-down list shows the workspaces within the samples repository. select austinapartments.fmw. Now select the service in which to run the workspace. The author registered this workspace with four different services. We'll talk more about services later when we publish and run our own workspace. For now, just select the data streaming service. Finally, click Run. FME assigns the workspace to an engine, which carries out the translation. The browser prompts to open a result, in this case a KMZ file, in an appropriate application. One final thing. Logging in as an administrator provides extra menu options for various configuration and maintenance tools. For example, you can set different levels of security, clean and back up the system, and manage the FME engines and how they are deployed. Thank you for viewing part one of this tutorial. The next video covers publishing our own workspace from FME Desktop to FME Server.